Having been in the insurance business for nearly 20 years, I've seen so many people come in, go to work on the right things, and change their lives forever. On the flip side, I've seen a larger amount of people come in and fail. It's estimated that on average, 90% of new life licensed agents quit within the first year, and 95% quit within the first five. From the outside looking in, this can be daunting until you start to observe and learn why people actually fail. Of the 90% of the people that quit in the first year, 85% of them did not follow through with the right habits day to day, out of the gate, and they didn't even give themselves a chance to win. The other 15% that fail usually had a life event take them out, an illness, a divorce, or a financial setback. Winning isn't hard if you follow a winner. That's why it's important to be on the right team with the right company. If you're considering joining the life insurance industry, reach out to me and I'll give you some feedback and point you down the right path. In this video, I clearly define the habits of a successful insurance agent. By the end of this video, you'll have a better idea of what it takes to win and how to avoid the pitfalls to be a part of the winning circle. So watch this to the very end. I want to be clear, the retention on my team is way higher than the industry average. And there's a reason for that. It's because we train our agents on these habits on a weekly basis to ensure that most of them make it through the year. Of the agents on my team that get licensed, 90% of them make it past their first year and 75% of them past the fifth year. The reason they make it is because they understand the habits of a winning agent. These habits are so easy to do, they're so easy not to do, and that's why most people fail. The first habit is you must be obsessed with your calendar. I think a lot of people think that they're obsessed with their calendar, but here's how I think that you should run your calendar. Firstly, if you handed me your calendar, I should know everything about your business, your life, your health, etc. I should be able to evaluate where you spend your time and how much income generating activity you're doing. The biggest thing I notice when I'm coaching in business is how much white space people have in their calendar. They literally have 2 and 3 hour chunks of white space in their calendar that are unaccounted for. You can only imagine what's going on during those times, and it's anything other than being productive. Broke people don't operate efficiently. I've come to that conclusion. Successful people are some of the most efficient people that I've ever met, and the answer lies within the calendar. I have two rules. Rule number one is that everything goes in the calendar, and that's non-negotiable. If it's important, then it goes in the calendar. If it's not important or it's not in line with your purpose, it shouldn't go in the calendar and you shouldn't plan on doing it. This allows me to think twice before committing to something, because if it goes in the calendar, it's taking up space in my life and it's taking away from other opportunities that I might have that could go in the calendar. We're all given a finite amount of time to live our life. We only have 24 hours in a day. Your calendar should be treated like the most valuable tool that you own. Rule number two is that everything in your calendar has to get done. This takes away a lot of the thinking, especially on days where I don't feel like doing things. If it's in my calendar, I'm gonna get it done. If I didn't put it in there, the days I don't feel 100%, I would not be doing it because I don't feel motivated. So once again, if it's in there, I have to do it, plain and simple. Don't overthink it, it needs to get done. My second point, time block every day to add new prospects to your list and make calls. Every day you should block off time to add new prospective clients to your list and make calls. Here's the problem that I see. Everybody does this in the beginning until they build a little bit of momentum or they start making some sales. As soon as they start making sales, they stop blocking off time to add names to their list and making calls because they think they're too busy. But in reality, they're now avoiding the uncomfortable things they did in the beginning to help them make the sales. And what ends up happening is their pipeline dries up. Every day you should sit down at your desk and add at least one or two names to your list. And these are people that you come in contact with from the previous day, people that you meet on social media, right? People that commented on your posts. In my business, we all are in the people business. So every name on that list is another opportunity either now or down the road. Most businesses are the same way. If you don't want to be one of the 90% of people that fail early on, it's a non-negotiable that you sit down every day and add people to your list. Separately from adding people to your list, you should be making calls. These are two separate buckets and should be done separately. When it's time to make calls, I like to get myself in the zone. I like to stand up and walk around and practice making a call a few times to myself or a teammate. It's really important that you make all your calls in bunches. Just think of it like going to the gym. Imagine if you went to the gym and you got all warmed up and every 2 hours you did a set. That's not gonna work, right? You gotta build momentum and do it all at once, and there's an energy that can be maintained through the process. Just remember, adding names to your list and making calls is not the sexy part of your business. I know that you'd much prefer doing presentations and making sales and getting paid. I get it. But those things will never happen without the first things. So stay consistent on the front end of the pipeline, and the money will consistently come on the back end. Now, before I move into the next one, if you want to know about more on how to partner with me and thrive in the insurance industry, make sure you check out the box in the link in the description box. You may be a fit for my team. So again, feel free to check out the link in the description box. With that said, let's move on. My next point, block time to sharpen the saw. Sharpening your saw means being proactive with learning your craft. Block time off every week to learn more about your product. Now, this is not a replacement for making calls. This is a 1 hour or 2 hours a week that you set aside to study things like product, how they work, how to get the benefit out for each client. You know, Stephen Covey wrote a book called The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. He said, give me 6 hours to chop down a tree and I will spend the first 4 sharpening the axe. For me, I find the best way to sharpen the axe is grab a partner. If I want to learn about a product, I'll book some time on a Zoom call with one of the product reps. There, I can talk to them exactly about how the products work. I love to get information from the source. Every week, you should have a goal to spend 15 or 20 minutes with one of your product reps or somebody else who can teach you how to sell the product. On the selling side, you should block off time every week to practice closing different kinds of products to one of your colleagues. You're never gonna get better if you don't practice. The good thing about practicing with somebody who is better than you is that they know what you should say and shouldn't say, so they're the hardest sale that you're gonna have to make. My next point, set clearly defined goals to start each month. Setting clearly defined goals helps trigger the proper behavior and helps you stay laser focused on the daily habits you need to stay on track. I have been setting goals for nearly 20 years, and I've tried almost every different way of doing it. I'll share with you my trial and error research after thousands of hours of goal setting. At the beginning of each month, it's important you take at least 60 minutes in a quiet place and rewrite out all your goals for the month. These goals should be in line with your 12-month plan, and if you've planned for the year appropriately, you already know that your month needs to look like in terms of goals. If you fall behind in the month before, your goals should be adjusted to stay on track. A lot of people miss their goals, and the problem they have is they start fresh each month and don't try and make up the month before. That's a result of failure, or that's gonna lead to failure in your business. Once you've set your clearly defined goals for the month, I want you to break them down into 4 weeks at a time. Each week is comprised of 7 days. Once the week starts, your only goal is to win every single day at a time. It's you against you for 7 days in a row. The month doesn't matter. The quarter doesn't matter. The year certainly doesn't matter if you can't accomplish your 7-day goal. You'll notice I said 7 days. That doesn't mean I work 7 days a week. If I have a family scheduled day on Sunday, I stick to that. If I have a business day, I stick to that. What you don't want is you don't want to be compromising your health time, your business time, your family time. You want to make sure you stick to it. If you're taking liberties and shortcuts in your calendar, then when you're at work, you're going to feel guilty that you should be at home. And when you're home, you're going to feel guilty like you should be working. Sticking to your 7-day game plan is a way for you to be present in all areas of your life and live guilt-free. The key is to be accountable on a weekly basis. It's the only way you can guarantee that your hard work will have a positive monthly outcome. You don't have 30 days to hit your goal, you have 7 days to accomplish the first task. And I want you to do it 3 more times after that in order to have a great month. My next point, review and evaluate your progress with an accountability partner at the end of the month. This one is huge and often overlooked because it can be hard on our ego. But remember, what you don't measure, you can never improve. A mentor reminded me a long time ago that I needed to inspect what I expect. People's unwillingness to evaluate themselves at the end of each month is killing them slowly. Rather than facing the music at the end of each month so that they can course correct, they never look at it. And every year they set a new 12-month goal and never accomplish it. On the flip side, it's important to evaluate at the end of each month so that you can also celebrate some of the wins. There's gonna be some months that you crush your goals, and if you don't debrief and evaluate at the end of each month, you never give yourself a chance to celebrate the little stuff along the way. These are some of the most effective habits of a successful insurance agent. If you can implement these habits, you can get on the path to greatness and build massive growth in your business. Remember, you're never gonna be perfect at any of these, but knowing them and working towards them every single day is all you can ask for. You will double and triple your business if you can get even 50% better at each one of these things. If you have any questions, drop a comment below. If you wanna know more about how to partner with me, click the link in the description box. I can't wait to hear how you've applied some of these tips and hopefully get you on a better path in your business. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.